Hey, Braidbosses and my natural hairstylist, it is Jen, your exclusive startup business coach. Yes, I want to come in and talk to you guys about, should you charge a travel fee? First of all, this video is brought to you by my Braid Here for Cash course. Make sure you're going in the description below and you're grabbing the course. Let's get right into it. Let's talk about some facts, okay? The facts are the facts are the facts. The facts are, the average person is driving 27 minutes to and from work. We're not talking about your business. We're not talking about a side hustle. To and from work. And the average person is also driving 25 miles to work. So, we know that in real life, they do not pay you to come to and from work. But I'm not here to shade nobody about their travel fee, honey. I'm just telling you. To and from work is 50 miles for the average person in the United States. Okay? Let's go to the second fact. Currently, right now, most cars, not everybody's, but most cars, the average car, does about 25 miles per gallon. Right, and the current average of gas right now is about $3 to $6 depending on where you are, right? And I don't think we quite hit the six yet, but many places, like I know the other day, I paid $5.25 for 91. Okay, so the average gas cost is about $3 to $6 depending on what state you're in. So we want to be realistic about your travel charge. Your travel charge should be somewhere between $5 to $20. Now, that's me being on the more liberal, you know, side of things. I've seen some people that are very conservative. They charge specifically what they want. But I'm thinking your travel charge should be somewhere between $5 to $20 if we look at this breakdown, okay? And then we're going to move away from the facts and let's go about specifically the best way you should be charging. So, first of all, you need to be very clear whether you do or do not charge a travel fee. That should be clear. Okay, if you have a booking site, if you have your website, if you have, you know, maybe on Insta, you might put willing to travel, right? Then the next thing you might want to also put is how many miles are you willing to travel? I actually did a poll for you guys on my community tab and I asked about how far you guys willing to travel. Some people said from 1 to 25 miles, some people said 26 miles to 50 miles, and other people said, hey, it just depends. Right, but you need to put this on your website, on your Instagram, on your Facebook, wherever you're promoting your braid business or your natural hairstyling business. Let people know how many miles you're willing to travel. Okay, then something that I used to do on my site is I would actually at the bottom of each, well, not each, on my price page. For those of you guys who do not know, I have two videos where I tell you guys how much you might want to charge for your braid. So I'm going to leave that, let it slide up here, and I'm going to let it slide down below. But what I used to do on my price page on my website is at the bottom, I would put surrounding areas that I'm willing to travel to. And I literally would have up to maybe, I want to say like 5 or 10 cities that I'm willing to travel to. Still going to be a travel charge, but just so people have an idea of where I will or will not go. Okay? So you want to either charge, there's three different ways you could charge. You could charge just a flat fee, which is saying, you know, whether I travel 1 mile or 50 miles, I'm going to charge you blah, blah, blah. Or you might say, this depends on your location. This can be up for discussion, or this is, you know, subject to vary. Or my favorite way is just bundle it in, right? And bundle it in is pretty much based on some of the first things we talked about. How many miles are you willing to travel? And what cities you go to. So, for example, if I say I'm willing to travel up to 50 miles, and I know my car, 1 gallon is 25 miles, that's $10. So, if I'm going to charge somebody, I don't even tell them I have a travel fee if they're in the 50 miles. I'm just going to bundle my travel charge within it. So, here's an example. Let's go to the example. So, an example is, say I say I'm going to do big feet and braids for $75. This person lives 20 miles from me, right? And that's round trip now. To and from, it's 20 miles to go, 20 miles to come. So that's 40 miles, right? And I already said, take $5 a gallon for 25 miles from my car, right? So that means I will need 2 gallons of gas to go to and from that person's house, and I'm gonna need my $10. So instead of me saying, oh, I'm going to charge you $75 and I have a $10 traveling fee, I just tell them straight up, I'm going to charge you $85. And psychologically, you guys, think about it, you guys. Many of us, we prefer not to be charged those small little fees. So it might be best to just bundle it in so people don't feel like, dang, I'm charging, I'm paying you for that, and I'm paying you for this. When you can just bundle it in, and they don't even have to know that you're charging them for that. So that's my example here. If I'm charging $75 for feeding braids, and I know that this person stays less than 50 miles from me, and I add the $10 on, I'm just going to tell them, look, I'm going to charge you $85. They don't know that I'm just going to charge $75, but since you're further from me and I have to travel to you, I'm going to charge a $10 fee, which is going to make this $85. So you guys, again, I hope that this was helpful. This was brought to you by my Braid Hair for Cash course. Make sure you're checking it out in the description below, and you let me know, do you currently charge a travel fee, and how do you charge your travel fee? Is it your travel fee? Is it flat fee? Does it depend on the location? Or do you just bundle it in like I suggest? So I'll be talking to you guys later. Bye, y'all.